About the compiler design subject now. I'll try to skip the theories quickly so that we can focus more on practice problems or the previous year question papers. So here I've discussed some of the theories in terms of slides and PPTs. I'm going to explain them again with side by side. And if you feel that you find any difficulty in understanding these topics, just do let me know. And I'm using this format because it is very fast and very convenient for us to skip or for us to study theory using this particular format. And then I'm also going to solve the questions step by step. I'm going to teach you everything step by step so that you will be able to cover everything in a very clear manner. Okay, so the subject name is compiler design. And what exactly is a compiler? See, you understand that there's a processor, and processor is a hardware. And the hardware, this when I'm saying processor is a hardware, and the execution of the program after compilation is done by the processor. Okay, and here compiler is a software. That means compiler takes a source program, and then compiler translates that particular source program to an object program. Okay, so at that object program can be anything. It can be assembly language code, it can be a relocatable machine code, or it can be an absolute machine code. It can translate this program to any one of them. That depends on the implementation of the compiler, that how we implemented the particular compiler. Okay, so this one more way, you can also represent it in one more way. You can say the source program can be high level language program, and whatever the object program you are going to get, that particular object program can be a low level language program, right? And it can be assembly code, it can be relocatable machine code, or it can be an absolute code. And here we use preprocessor, that I will explain what is a preprocessor. But just understand that a preprocessor is used to do preprocessing before compilation. That preprocessor converts all the user convenience code into intermediate code, which is an understandable format by the compiler. That we will discuss, don't worry. So here from this slide, you just need to understand that compiler is a language processor. This is a major word. Compiler is a language processor. That means it is just going to process a language which translates a source program, like here it translates a source program into an object program. And when I'm saying object program, it can be anything. It can be a assembly language program, it can be locatable machine code, it can be absolute code. And what is this assembly language? Assembly language means, if you studied the subject computer architecture and organization, you studied some of the instructions like add R0, R1, or jump J and Z, jump if zero or jump if non-zero, these kinds of instruction. These are the instructions which are in assembly language. And these instructions depends on the CPU architecture, or you can say a processor architecture. When I'm saying relocatable machine code, absolute machine code, this topic you studied in operating system. That means what is a relocatable machine code, what is an absolute machine code. And when I'm saying absolute machine code, that means to every instruction we are going to give a physical address. Before studying this relocatable machine code and absolute machine code, it is recommended that you should go for the videos of memory management in case of operating system, because there I explained everything, what is a absolute machine code and what is a relocatable machine code. Okay, so now you understand that what is a compiler. Now there are different phases in a compilation process. While you are executing a program, there are different phases. So you can say, first of all, you are giving a skeleton source program. That skeleton source program is generally written in high level language. Like if you have a program like this, for example, main, some line changes, and having in some section hi, this is start of the program, this is start of program. You may be having some instructions like integer a comma int b. You may be having some hash defined statements like hash define stdio.h, hash define ns5, or you can have hash include stdio.h, and you may be having some other types of instruction. It can be like type def integer si, etc, etc. These kind of instructions can be there. Now this complete program is also called as a skeleton source program, or you can also say it as high level language program. Now you give this entire high level language program to a preprocessor. Now when I'm saying preprocessor, there are different functionalities of preprocessor which we will discuss, but just now just understand that the responsibility of preprocessor is to preprocess the program before even giving it to a compiler. And when I'm saying preprocessor, that means the responsibility of preprocessor is to remove all the extra white spaces, from the program. It removes new line characters from the program, it removes comments from the program, it resolves all the hash define statements, and it resolves all the type definition statement, etc. It resolves all the type definition statement. What does that mean? What does that exactly mean? See, just understand that whenever you are writing a program in multiple lines of code, that multiple lines of code is, you know, we write it for the understanding, for human understanding, because it is, you know, it is kind of very difficult for us to figure out the entire program when it is kind of a mess, right? So that is why we give a structure to a program. We write the program in multiple lines so that that multiple lines of code will be, you know, that will look very convenient to our human eye, so that we'll be able to understand that a particular statement is finished at that particular line, or there's a particular structure of the program, so that it will be very easiest for us to understand, right? So that, but that multiple lines of code is not required by a processor. Right, so processor, even if you write the entire program, even if you write a 1000 lines of code program in one single line, your preprocessor will be able to understand that particular program. Preprocessor or your compiler does not require the program to be written in multiple lines. That is just for the understanding of the programmer or for human being, right? Because if you write an entire 1000 lines of code within one single line, then you will be you will not be able to understand the entire program. Okay, secondly, it removes all the comments. These comments are for the understanding of the programmer or the for the understanding of human being. We require the comment, but the compiler does not require the comments. So the responsibility of preprocessor is to remove the comment. Responsibility of preprocessor is to remove those hash defined statements. See, let me just tell you what is hash defined statement. What do I mean by hash defined statement? Assuming that in C language you are having certain program, like a main function is there, and you are having integer a is equal to 5, and you're defining integer b with size a. That means you're creating an array with size a and you're putting some values. Now this particular case, you can see we are trying to allocate memory dynamically to this integer b, or okay, say to this array b, and this dynamic memory allocation is not allowed, because we are giving the, you know, on runtime there will be memory which will be allocated to a. In that memory we are going to store 5, and on runtime we will know that what is the size of that particular array. But sometimes it required that there's a particular variable, there's a particular value which can be changed at later point of time. For example, we have the value of pi. We know the value of pi is 3.14. What if we are using this value of pi multiple times in our program, and in maybe thousand times, and maybe in future someone will prove that 3.14 is not the correct value. So we have to change that particular value. So better way is to write hash define n as 3.14 or some other values like this. And when we are defining some values like this, that means in the entire program, instead of writing 3.14, we can just write n. And when we can just write n, then later part of time we can change this 3.14 value. We can change this 3.14 value here, and in the entire program this value will be changed. Okay, and this is how we use the hash define statements, right? So we can remove this hash define statement while execution of the program. Okay, so let us